That's not supposed to happen. Not light enough. Pink. That ain't gonna work. Okay, let's try my last hope. Light enough. I can definitely fill the roll. Okay, well, with that in mind, that works. It's definitely the right tone anyway. Two-toned wings, that's what those are. They have an undercolor, and an overcolor. am definitely not the Birdman of Alcatraz. I bet he had a technique for birds. Temporarily move these. So I can move my hand. That's actually a highlighted color, and I don't know what color that is. See, the underside of those wings is a completely different color than the top. We are talking about a hummingbird, so it's not a shock to learn that. Question is, what color to use? I don't... I don't have a live hummingbird to go by. That's fascinating. I don't have a live hummingbird to go by. No, that's not right. That's not right at all. Now I got another problem. Let's see. What am I doing here? Always a wise idea to clean the lens of your magnifying glass if you use one. Like if you're blind like me, you know. Thank you. hope and pray that works. So you can see right through those, the underside of those wings. Wow. I have no idea how to make that happen. Yeah, the underside of those wings are a completely different color. So I think what I'm going to do, because you can see right through, I'll put this away. Yes. have available. See if I can get it even close. So, I don't need this or that. Don't need that. Or that. Or that. And I might use this. What color is it? God damn it. Cobalt green. Not a green. I'm not looking for green. So this is this. Ultramarine. Paleo blue. Might try that. Oh, I used up all my space here. Absolutely no weight on the pencil whatsoever, just the weight of the tip only. Just let the pencil do the work. I don't know if it'll work, but this is the only thing I know to do to fix this. Weight of the tip of the pencil only, nothing else. Okay. And then there's some gray down the bottom part. So this is interesting. Shows up, remains to be seen. And that just the bottom part of the, not even a four, not even a two. Not even a fourth, it's like a few percentage points of each wing. It's got some gray in it down at the bottom. They're a different color on the outside than they are on the inside, but remember, we are talking about a hummingbird. Yep. No idea why that's there. Thank you. rooms again. For wings on a hummingbird, especially as small as that one is, I'm going to say that's pretty well detailed right there. Just like that. But I need to get out the gray again, that light gray. Say the wings are in pretty good condition. Okay. This over here. Put this way. So I say we finish the body tomorrow. I think I will. Okay, hopefully I can get a little bit further today than I got yesterday. An unusual color is required. Belly of the beast. Okay, you can't actually see it, but the belly of the beast is a kind of a yellowish, greenish sort of an artichoke, but not an artichoke. The prismacolored jasmine mostly resembles what color that is, so I'm gonna mix that with some brown in order to provide the shading. Yeah, that should work. Yeah. Where's my... I'm thinking maybe I should do the feathers on top first. That's probably what I should do. Yeah, maybe. Well, let's take a look at what I planned on doing for the feathers on top. What color was that? That was a dark green. Dark thalio green. And then there was a darker color. Yeah, I'm going to use that dark gray that warm gray 5. Yeah, I think these two colors will make up those feathers. Okay. Thank you. pictures of this bird. Well, they're not all. Kind of patchy and splotchy. And use that dark gray. Probably should have laid down the dark gray first. Put the green over that, that would make more sense. But when was the last time I did anything that made any sense? Because the dark feathers on the back of this bird are really dark. I'm wondering if what I'm doing is the right color. This warm gray 5. Intricate work. This is the kind of stuff that'll show you where your patience are and whether or not you actually have any.